What is up, guys? I am back, and I've got so much to share y'all in the next coming days here. I've got things going on left and right, three or four things happening really at the same damn time. I am currently in my bathroom, and I just wanted to show you guys the progress of what we've done in here. And when I say that I'm very impressed by myself, because this is my first time I've ever done this, and I'm satisfied with the work that I've done, and I've been meticulous, and I've been very thorough in just making sure that everything is perfect as I can get it. And let me just tell you, I'm just very, very proud of the work that I've done here, and I am just beyond excited to get this thing finished up and buttoned up so we can use this. So here we go. This is what I've got here, guys, and it's almost done. It's almost done. I've got a little bit on the curb to do left. I've got the faces of the curb. Top of the curb is already done though, so. And I've got this to do right here, and just some buttoned up sheetrock work, which isn't very significant. Can slap that up anytime really. The grout needs to be done still on the grout lines on the walls and on the shower floor. So what you're seeing right there, the white in between the lines, that's just the thin set under it. I've completely cleaned the floor. That's why I've got plastic on it right now from when I've been doing grout here. I have officially gotten done with one wall. Almost just some pencil lines that I have to fill in here. And that'll be taken care of. And so I've grouted the niche completely, grouted the wall completely. Looks phenomenal. I've got a light grout in there. I don't know how good you can tell that, but I'm really digging it. I've got some spots to come up and touch up, but it's pretty routine for grouting. You're gonna have air bubbles, and you're gonna have imperfect textures sometimes when you're doing grout here. So that I'm just beyond happy with the result of what this has turned into. I think it looks great, and I really do like this accent line as well. I don't know if you can tell from far away, but it's definitely just like an aqua kind of color in there, along with some stone looking colors and some translucent colors and stuff. Still gotta clean this stuff up a little bit on the main wall, just a tad, to get it prepped and ready to grout, just like these bad boys over here. And I'm really digging the hardware. The valves look awesome to me. There's one that's gonna be able to control this bad boy, that fixed shower head up here, and then there's gonna be a wand right there. So that's nice. I've got this all ready to go. I just needed to grout. That's actually ready to be put up and sealed at this point. I am going to go ahead and do that very soon. And unfortunately, I ran into a problem with the grout. It's like, I don't know, my third time grouting, and this has never happened to me before. But I started to mix up some grout, and I did the whole wall. I barely got it done though, guys. This grout that I have, it mixed really well, and it was creamy. Had a little bit of thickness to it, so I added some more water, got it all nice and fluffy and creamy, and I began to put it on the wall. Went really good at first. I stirred up at the top of the wall and started to work my way down. So, grout, it has an expiration time far less than thinset, right? And I was aware of this. This is, my third or fourth time doing this. So I knew that I had to move. When you mix the stuff up, you gotta move. And I was moving. I was moving good. And, I thought I was making good time. I was getting rows knocked down, two or three rows at a time, and then coming back, and sponging it off, getting the excess off, making sure that there's no big chunks that were going to dry onto the tile face itself. And so, I was doing that. All of a sudden, I come back to my bucket. This stuff had started setting up so hard, so quick. I've never seen grout set up this quick in my life. If you have any comments or suggestions to me, if you're experienced with this kind of stuff, please help me understand, because this stuff was a nightmare to work with. And as a result, I've got a wasted bucket right here. This is actually my second bucket that I made. Unfortunately, I added too much water on my second bucket and I had to throw the whole bag in. It was so liquidy that second time that I had to work with it for like an hour to get it to set up to where it was actually workable and malleable, and it would stick together enough to actually get it to slap on the wall. Again, like 5, 10 minutes into it, this stuff had already like almost turned rock solid, and I have no idea why or how, because as far as I know, I was doing everything right. And the mixture on the second batch was even more astonishing to me, because you would think that more water, having to work with it until it burned out, would be in this case like better, even though it wasn't the right consistency at first. Eventually it got to the right consistency, but you would think that it wouldn't start setting up as fast. I mean, it set it up even faster than the other stuff. And I mean, this other stuff, I had like a little quarter bucket mixed, not much at all, and this stuff just set up so quick. Never seen that in my life. But anyways, I'll stop rambling about grout because I know that's probably boring to some of y'all. But I just want to show you guys what is going on here and how awesome this all looks, and I'm just beyond excited about it. This isn't done because I actually ran out of these pieces. I'm gonna have to order some more. I'm gonna do the same pieces on the curb as we're doing here. So I've gotta use 16 more pieces in total. I've already counted, got them ordered, and those should be there soon. So unfortunately, that was my only bag of grout, and I've gotta go get some more grout. And no one in Asheville has that grout, that specific make and model and color. So gonna have to go call Charlotte, the tile shop in Charlotte, and get that set up. Fortunately, my parents still live there, so they can just pick it up for me. And whenever they come up next, they will be able to give that to me, or we can just meet halfway or something, so I can pick it up and go ahead and tackle the rest of this wall. But that is pretty much it, and we're done. I mean, this shower has been in the works for a while, just because it's been me really working on it, and kind of no one else except for my dad here and there. He would come up, a couple times every now and then, but he's got his own stuff going on. This is all me, guys. This, for the most part, this is all me, and I'm really happy about it. My wife, Kayla, Dandy, as she calls herself on YouTube now, is doing a new YouTube channel, and I wanted to get to that, but I also wanted to tell you that she's actually helped me on some of this tile work, buttering tile, and sometimes even putting them on the wall. and adjusting them and stuff for me while I make the cuts and get everything to the right size and cut the right shapes out and stuff. So that was really cool, getting my wife involved in the back half of this project here. And it really helped speed it up too for the last part, because, you know, getting to the end, like, it's so much work. Kind of burnt out on it, honestly. It was very taxing to be able to take so much time and make sure everything is absolutely spot on, absolutely perfect, and at least as perfect as I can get it. Like I said, you know, first time doing this, not everything is going to be perfect, and I've had to understand and kind of take a step back and realize, like, hey, it doesn't have to be perfect. It just has to be functional, right? Perfection is probably kind of one of my downfalls in housework, if you can tell. But, so, I mean, nonetheless, I mean, still phenomenal work. I really loved and enjoyed doing every kind of part of this. Even the hard parts, you know, I just take pride in doing that. So that's exciting. Anyways, moving on. I've got another little surprise for y'all, and you guessed it, granite. So I'm gonna take this stuff off here real quick and show you guys, kind of uncover this real quick. Oh yeah. I've got sink hardware, backsplash, and granite. Oop. Little stuff on there. I'm gonna have to clean that off. No matter. It's just a little bit. But yeah, it's not like sealed or anything yet, so I gotta seal it still. I've got the sinks installed. They're actually being supported down here right now. By these wooden contraptions, but I got the plumbing all hooked up. Faucet is functional, ready to go, ready to work. It's beautiful. I love it. I guess that's good enough for y'all, but I just wanted to show you, like, it's got a little purple in it. And it's actually really inexpensive for such a nice piece. I got this kind of like pencil rounding on it. Looks really sleek, really modern, contemporary, just looks phenomenal, I think. And I haven't put the vanity hardware on yet, but I think it looks really good with the sink set up and the granite of choice that we chose. And it's gonna go really well with that shower right there once it's all finished and done. And got the tile cleaned up a little bit more again. So just thought I'd show you that real quick. Ain't she a beaut? Really cool tile. And it's got the heated floor too. So we're gonna enroll in this bathroom very soon, hopefully. I gotta start looking at vendors for doing the shower wall, shower door. I've got glass to put in. If anyone has a suggestion, lives in Asheville, knows people in Asheville for companies, I'd love to hear who you have to offer. I've already got a couple of people that I'm looking at. Just haven't made the phone call yet, so gotta do that. Kind of got sidetracked the other day. Well, not the other day, but for a couple weeks or so. I've been, like I said, I've been doing a lot of other work as well. I've been dealing with a plumbing problem, a draining issue for a while, ever since last summer. I had to get someone out here at first to just unclog the drain, because, like, literally all the tubs, both the tubs, well, one tub and then one walk-in, because this used to be a walk-in as well, just not nice at all. And it was very disgusting. This was like the most disgusting room in the house. So it's awesome to actually look at it, and it looks nice now. But the tub and the walk-in shower, like all the sinks in the house, they backed up, like sewer water was coming up from the pipe. So I was like, oh shit, I gotta get someone in here pronto because I don't have the tools and I don't know where the blockage is. So they figured it out, or so I thought. And they unclogged it and we were fine for a while. No issue. Come back, fast forward to like 3 weeks ago, 4 weeks ago, this problem while I was taking a shower started to arise and the toilet would start bubbling. Like air would come up through the toilet. And I was like, what the hell is that? And I thought it was coming from the shower at first. I was like, it's like a snake or something down there. Like, what if something comes up? Like, but I noticed because the toilet lid was open one time when I was taking a shower, and I was like, oh shit, here the snake is. And like, it's not a snake, but I knew I had a problem again at that point. And so I called the guy back that came out the first time. He was familiar with the property. He knew where his makeshift clean out was that he made when he came the first time a while back during that summer. And come to find out, there's actually a one-way clean out on the house too. He did not find it the first, second, or third time. The fourth time someone came out here, he came out here, he figured that out. So you can kind of see, like, I've had this problem going on, but it got really bad all of a sudden, just like, a few weeks ago. So he fixed it that time, and then he left, and I was about to go out of town, and all of a sudden the toilet started bubbling again, and I was like, why? And I just wanted it to be fixed, and like it was just a headache having to deal with that still because like I'm building this nice bathroom and there we have a plumbing problem which is just atrocious and it's costing me money. I'm hemorrhaging money because of this. It's getting expensive to keep having the roto guy come out and unclog my drain here, like without actually fixing the problem. And so, I basically just splurged and went ahead and got a guy out here with a camera and we fed it down the line. He fed it down the line and towards the street. I thought it might have been a problem up towards the house at first because just old plumbing, Something is going on maybe that might be clogging the drain enough to make that effect happen. And it was clogging quick too. And the other bathroom is on the other side of the house on the back side. So for it to clog that quick, coming up from the main drain, it's pretty severe. So he fed it up this way into the house, nothing. Pipes smooth as can be, smooth as a baby's ass, and went back down the street. And if you've ever noticed in one of my videos, there's trees in front of my property. There's a big tree in particular that is was the problem that I was experiencing. And like I can't say I'm surprised that a tree was screwing with the old drain. What I thought to be an old drain. Come to find out, the drain system to the main sewer, the city, it had been replaced already. There's PVC there, and that was actually pretty nice to find because that meant that I might not have to replace everything. And that's what I was really concerned about, was having to replace the whole thing, down to the street. Fortunately, though, that's not the case. A tree root had found its way into a badly sealed joint in the PVC, and it had caused a major blockage. I mean, when I'm talking about major, like, I cut this thing out, and I don't know how water was getting through it. It was so clogged. Just black, earthy material. I mean, shit, toilet paper, human waste, that kind of thing. Fortunately, it was just mine and my wife's, and but it was still gross. Ew. I don't want to be touching that. And that was something that I had to deal with. I spent the whole day yesterday and today. I dug yesterday, after the guy marked where I needed to dig. Dug down. If anyone knows what lying down in ground is like, it's 3 feet. So I'm gonna just say that right now. It's not something that you can do just like in 20 minutes. You're gonna be digging. So I spent yesterday the majority of the day trying to track down, trying to dig down to where I could find where, the problem was. And I had about 5 feet dug out in a row, coming towards the tree where he marked and everything. He didn't know, 100% where it was exactly, but it was somewhere around where he marked. So fortunately today, about 20, 30 minutes in, found the problem. Huge root system just pushing its way through a bad sealed joint. And I took care of it. Used a Sawzall and cut the section out that needed to be replaced. Foot and a half either direction. Put some new 4-inch PVC hard connection line in, and with a rubber boot on the other end so I could flex it on to the other half after I made the hard connection, and she's good to go. So that's one project that we've had to deal with that I didn't expect to be dealing with personally. And it's safe to say I'm glad that it did not happen worse. I'm really glad that I didn't have to do anything else to the line, like replacing the whole thing or something, just because it was rotted out or like just poor shape or just old, whatever, all of the above. So that's some of what I've been dealing with here, guys. And I've got a lot more to show you too, that we've done. And can't wait to get this bathroom up and running. I mean, to some degree, it looks unfinished still, but I mean, that's nothing. Like, I can throw that up in nothing, no time. So, it might look bad to some of y'all. It might just be like, oh, well, nothing else is done. And you'd be correct, I guess, but that was the hard part. That's smooth sailing from here on out. I'm done. Like, I'm so happy to be at this point in the bathroom build. And I'm about to do it all again. Because the hall needs to be done. And it's got concrete pad that it's floating on, over joists and everything. And so it's gonna have to be knocked out. Got a bunch of old tile, and I gotta revamp the tub in there. We're gonna slap it back in or find a new one. Just recoloring it and refinishing it, though. We'll have to get someone to do that. But the rest of the stuff, I mean, it's all me. So stay tuned, guys. I will let you know what else has been going on really soon after this video. I've also got another backpacking video that I haven't even touched at all. If obviously you've seen that I haven't been on YouTube lately, this is why, because I just didn't feel like I had time to comfortably, work on editing video and stuff lately. I'm posting this video right from my phone. I just have no time to edit. I gotta go eat. I got a steak to cook tonight. I'm cooking out with my wife, and I am gonna make some barbecue chicken for her, because she don't eat steak. She's a heathen, and we are just gonna chill out. Jeez, I'm tired from digging today. I'm tired from putting the dirt back, and the whole process of that. fixing the pipe was easy. I mean, that was like 5 seconds. To get to it took a while. So I'm tired, but I'm gonna go, guys. I hope you have a wonderful rest of your weekend. It is Saturday night. I hope that you're enjoying your evening. I hope that you're enjoying each other's company, and I hope that y'all are all being safe doing it. Remember, COVID is still a thing, so wear your damn mask. Stay home when you can, and just don't be a dumbass, I guess. Peace.